Hi, I'm Jamie.
I'm Shelby, and this is Reggie. Hiya. And this is Bella.
We travel the globe in our self-converted Eco Daily named Ivy.
You are now watching Expedition Rebellions!
Hey, what is up, you guys? This is part 3 of the Nature's Head toilet video.
So we're going to separate this video into 2 different sections. One is for your number one. The other one is for, you know, your number 2. You know what I mean? We have 4 questions we're going to answer on each topic. So let's get started!
So we start on number 1s. First question is, has it made our lives any easier? I'd say
yeah.
100%.
It's a lot easier to go to the toilet.
100%. Before this, it was more like public toilets or finding a toilet, what we could use. But yeah, 100%, it's made it easier. I was gonna say, emptying it, we've had this for about a week now, these toilets, and emptying it, the number ones has been seriously easy because all you have to do is open a valve and release it.
I seem to be quite good at that one. I'm quite lucky I've not emptied the poo bucket, number 2 bucket.
But yeah, apart from that, it's definitely made his life easier, number 1. Was it cost effective? Yes, 100% it was cost effective, but it didn't cost us anything, just time and labour really to put it in the van. But there was no real cost to it. Even the screwed rod, everything was free. Was there any downsides?
I'd probably say the smell.
Yeah, the only downside we've really got is after a while, once the container starts getting filled up, like even to like a quarter of a tank, you start getting a back smell.
But yeah. I wouldn't say it's there all the time.
But it definitely does smell.
Yeah,
100% definitely smells. What would you change if you did it again? The only thing I would change if I did it again, I'd put some kind of valve on it so that I could switch it off to stop the smell coming up from the tank, so that when you wasn't using it, it would be shut off completely, so you didn't have no smell coming up. That's the only thing I'd really change, to be fair. I haven't done it yet. I might do it in the future. I'm considering it.
Moving on to number 2. Has it made our lives easier? I'd say yeah.
Yeah, I think both of them 100% has made it completely different and easier while we're out in the van. Before this, we just relied on public toilets and anywhere we could really get to or go to. We don't have to like
wait for 2 days.
Or go into a restaurant or whatever you have to do to just go. At least we've got some facilities to go to, really. Was it cost effective? Yes, I'd say it's 100% cost effective again. I had to buy 2 tubs though because the first one shattered and broke. But it's still 100% cost effective. Probably cost me about £40 for this one, maybe £50 max. It might have been cheaper than that, to be fair. It might have been about £30. Yeah, it was really, really cheap. A lot cheaper than the £1,000 Nature Head toilets, what you can buy.
What are the downsides?
I'd say the biggest downside is the outside of your van smelling.
We
don't really have any smell inside the van because it's all closed off. Apart from when you're just about to go. But the fans can take most of that away. But the one problem you do have is if around the outside of your van, definitely when if you've just been in quite a recent time, you can have quite a bad odour around the outside of your van. It's not the best.
You'd have to have the fans on quite a long time for it to...
Yeah, to produce enough air through to get rid of the smell. What would you change if you did this again?
What you can change.
There's always better ways to do things, but I can't personally think of anything what I would change with it, to be fair.
How would you say emptying went?
Yeah, the emptying was very simple, to be fair. We didn't actually have to bury anything the first time we've had to do it. The plan was to compost it, but we've actually put it down a big drain hole and then wash it down, so it was really easy just emptying it down the drain hole. I think it'll make a difference when we have to actually dig a hole and bury it into the ground like.
So that's about it for tonight, guys. If you enjoyed mine and Jamie's company, give us a thumbs up and a subscribe.